You may think I'm always great at nails, but I lied. Well, hello everyone, it's me, Christine, again, and I had a lot of fun roasting your nails recently. But then it occurred to me that maybe a lot of you think I'm amazing or some shit at nails. But you know what? YouTubers aren't always as perfect as they appear on camera. I was doing some spring cleaning and found a few nail fail skeletons in my hard drive, and I think it's finally time to show you. So here is 6 of my never before published nail fails, because I just thought they looked f***ing ugly. That's pretty much it. First up, a powder chrome fail. Right when this powdery chrome shit hit the market, I was feeling ambitious and thought, what if I use nail vinyls to make chrome stickers that I could just stick on my nail? So I laid some vinyls down on a silicone nail mat, added some glossy gel taco, peeled the vinyls up before I cured it, then cured that shit for a minute to make it hard. And yes, it looks like nothing is there. Then I dipped the little sponge applicator in some silver chrome and buffed it on top of my DIY chevron shape. At this point, I thought I was a genius. I mean, holy shit, that could be really cool, right? Imagine all the possibilities. Except, yeah, it kind of looks a little see-through. And then I stuck it on my nail and it looked like this. Turns out, gel is really hard to make layers stickers like this with, and as soon as I brushed a taco over top of it all, the silver just went everywhere. Good idea, bad execution. Next up, rewind to December 2015, a time long before Polish Mountain. Were you there? I had seen a few rainbow scratch art videos on YouTube and I was inspired to see if I could make it work on my nails. So I did a bunch of different backgrounds on my nails for the base. I first tried coating the colorful nail with black India ink, and that's apparently what some of the scratch artists use and they say work best. But it stained my fucking skin. Acetone would not get it off. Unfortunately, I don't have a video clip of this, but it stained my pinky nail as well for like months. It had to grow out. Even when it dried, it was not scratching, so I had to peel that shit off. Then I tried some black tempera paint, and it was just ripping up everything under it. And yes, it had dried for like an hour. And then I tried black acrylic paint. All the experts in the scratch art domain said that acrylic paint was the worst for this, because it doesn't really scratch off that well, and the lines aren't so clean. But it was kind of working. Unfortunately, I just couldn't make any discernible patterns or pictures. And then I peeled it off. I tried so hard to get this to work, and I was able to draw this on my thumb. I don't know what it is. Anyways, I gave up. Next up, back in September, I was looking fly with silver halo on my nails. And I thought, I'm gonna do a really cute but edgy cat manicure. In my head, I was thinking, what if I took black acrylic paint, diluted it with a bunch of water so that you kind of get that smoky effect. So that when you fill in the holes in a nail vinyl stencil, the most concentrated part of the black acrylic and water mixture would stick around the outer edges, so the outlines of the cat heads, and you'd get this like cool outlined cat head effect. I thought of this after I did the same technique with acrylic and water for these mermaid nails. It created this cool outline. And so I wanted evil, smoky black cats on my nails. I peeled it up and it just looks like the kitty cats got washed out. Damn, I tried. So then I tried it again. This time with a thicker concentration with more black acrylic to water. I don't know what I was thinking, because it kind of just looks like I smothered one of those black masks on my nails. And yeah, you couldn't even tell that they were cats. So I peeled it off and moved on and ended up doing these black and pink gradient cat heads instead that I really liked. And so you guys may have seen that these ones did go on my channel. Next up, we got a really good example of Christine trying to be sexy and failing.
I'm falling.
I wanted it to look like a sexy sheer nude underneath of a mermaid pattern. So first, I made my nails milky. I know, like who does this? Milky white bullshit polish. And then I added some black sheer polish and it just looked dirty. But I carried on because sometimes you gotta see the whole idea through to then decide it looks like shit. Put on some liquid latex, slap some mermaid vinyls on, and added a little slit down the middle. That's supposed to be the sexy part. And then took some beautiful multi-chrome flaky polish and sponged that shit on. Dab, dab, dab. Peeled it off, and I was very underwhelmed, to say the least. What is this shit, Christine? You could do better than this. I thought, well, maybe if I add some sexy fine lines, we can recover from this. Fishnet, maybe? That's sexy, right? Then I added a glossy taco because I was actually trying to convince myself that this looked good. And then, fun fact, I took that off and then did these nails, which were a slightly less ugly version of the previous one because the base has hollow in it, obviously. And these ones did end up on my channel. See, kids, sometimes it's okay to make things that look like shit because the next time you do it, it'll probably look a little less shitty. April 2015, wow, look at this historical, mythical, ancient creature. I was in an iCat design mood because I'd just done these ones and I thought they looked pretty cool. So I wanted to try a different iCat pattern and use different colors. I've said before that iCat is a great design choice for people who can't draw for shit because, like dry brushing, it's an excuse to just scribble everywhere. I don't know if it was the poor choice of types of polish or it was just getting way too thick, but it started to get all sorts of gloppy on me. I was just looking more like a sludgy clusterfuck of polish rather than a very crisp and sharp iCat design. I'll be honest, I don't think this is one of the worst nail fails. I mean, it's not that bad. I don't need to use a false sense of modesty to fish for compliments. It's not bad. It's just, it wasn't my favorite. And I liked the other iCat design I'd already posted better, so this one just seemed kind of shitty in comparison. For some reason, I also took pictures of it and made a thumbnail before deciding I didn't want to post it. And finally, the last nail fail I found for you is from May 2015. And oh, it's one for the ugly books. Back in the day when I did some swatches for indie brands, I used to do swatches with a twist. In other words, having an accent nail with some kind of design using all the colors in that particular collection. And this was for one of Fun Lacquer's collection full of multi-chrome glitter polishes. If you're from the Simply Snap Squad, then you would recognize that I wore one of these recently. The polish was beautiful. I was using hollow striping tape. I was dabbing with a sponge. All the ingredients for an amazing nail art recipe were there. I was trying to go for a stained glass window look, but then I felt like the windows were not so clearly defined. So I decided to define them with a tiny brush and white acrylic paint, and oh boy.
And I misspelled in front of the entire school the word failure.
Why did I think I could paint such tiny lines? I don't know. Then I added a glossy taco of denial. Then immediately pulled my fingers away from the camera because I realized, what the f*** is this, Christine?
No.
I took all these pictures anyways, otherwise I wouldn't have had swatches of this collection. But none of these photos saw the light of day. These are like embarrassing nudes to me. And now I've leaked them myself. And there you have it, some of my nail fails that I've never published before because I just thought they look f***ing ugly. I just want to say that everyone has their own opinion of what they don't like of their own work, and we are always our harshest critic. And I don't think all of these nails are necessarily the worst nail fails ever. But hey, I'm just trying to fit in with the dramatic YouTuber techniques, okay? Give me a break. I know I haven't posted that many nail art videos recently, and yeah, one of the bigger reasons is because I broke my nail and it was just not in any condition to be painted upon. But at the same time, I've been having a lot of fun making different types of videos for you guys. And I just want to say that I really appreciate that you guys love whatever I make, whether it's nails, makeup, or some random shit. While yes, I love nail art, I also really enjoy making funny videos that make people laugh. Just call me simply whatever the fuck logical. Alright guys, hope you enjoyed my fails. If you happen to have a nail fail soon, then you can just come back to this video so you can feel better about yourself. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see y'all later. Bye!